Okay, so here we are going to cover the basic thing. So we have cyber threat intelligence, its importance, different types, life cycles, strategies we are going to use, capabilities, maturity models, and the frameworks. Then, first of all, we need to start with the simple intelligence. So when I talk about the word intelligence, it's just like you can say any information which is actually processed and classified, right? If the information is perfectly processed by any expert or any human being, because I can say being a human being, you are actually working so hard. We have that intelligence that we can process the information and then classify it. And based on that, we can identify the threat. So in a similar way, every expert, that's why every organization is, you can say, simply hiring the threat analyst. So they can able to use their intelligence to be aware of any attack or something happening in the world or in a simple internet world, I can say. So these things can be included. Now, then comes the difference between the data, information, and the intelligence. And then we have the intelligence-led security testing, a simple terms we can use for the testing part. So starting with this, first, I can say, okay, why it's taking so much time of today? Okay, let me start from here. The first thing in this module, if we talk about, is simple definitions or terms, which is related. So we will be covering first is the terminologies, different terminologies, which is related to this course. So first I have is the cyber threat. Okay, so what do you think? What is cyber threat?
Any compromise to any digital system or digital information or data, or an attempt thereof.
Yeah, or I can say, like you are right. In a simple term, I can say if there is some possibility of performing an attack, some loophole is here, and with that loophole, you can plan some attack, some malicious action can be taken, and with that action, your organization is at risk. Your organization is at risk. So I can say that will be a cyber threat. Okay, but simply the possibility.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. But the loophole is the vulnerability, right?
Yeah, the loophole we have is the vulnerabilities. Mm-hmm. That one vulnerability is gonna, you can say, simply rise a threat. If there is a possibility, the only the reason we have the possibility is due to the loophole. So I can say the possibility of performing any malicious action and which is gonna damage my organization assets, that can be a cyber threat. Mm-hmm. And that is because of a loophole. The second term we have is a vulnerability. So I think that is clear to you. Simple.
Yeah.
The loopholes, a simple weakness, I can say something which is some error is present. Something simply you can say which can be easily compromised. Which can be easily compromised can be a vulnerability. Then you have heard about the 0-day.
Yeah.
So what is the 0-day?
So it's when a patch is not released yet for a certain software.
Yeah.
So the attack happens before the vulnerability is known.
Yeah, absolutely correct. When the patch is not released, but attack is already happened. Or you can say simply, the vulnerability is already being exploited. We can say that is your 0-day. Then we have the exploit. Exploit is just like when we have some vulnerability, we have some, you can say simply, which is giving some threat. I'm going to take the advantage of that vulnerability. I will try to get into that particular system through that vulnerability. And from there, I can do so many malicious things over that particular, even I'm going with a system or some organization part, I can try that, right? Okay, then have you heard about the APT? Advanced Persistent Threat.
Yeah.
Yeah, what does it mean?
It's basically a sophisticated way of attacking. It can take a very long time. It's very well funded, therefore.
Yeah.
And it's very professional. Yeah, these people are usually part of organized crime.
Yeah, exactly.
Nation state actors, etc.
Yeah, right. So if the terms come as an APT, I can say which is actually gonna stay for a longer time. Simple thing. It's gonna stay for a longer time. It's gonna focus on stealing every information he get from the victim machine without even the user is able to, you can say, aware about it. You will not be even get aware about it. The things is going on. Like we use mobile. We have so many, you can say, third-party applications in the mobile. So once I'm going with some pirated website or some third-party apps I'm using, they have the pre-installed APT, right? Mm. They have these things. So once you go with that particular things and the APT is installed in your mobile or in your system when you're using some pirated website, so there is a possibility of attack. And it will stay for a longer time. It will get all the information from there. It can even affect your simple computer performance, your connection, your internet connection. That can also be affected. Your operating system, everything will be at risk in a simple way. Okay, next we have is a risk. Risk, I think, you know, which is simply, if I talk about the definition of a risk, is just a degree of uncertainty. Degree of uncertainty of any potential damage which is going to happen to the organization. That can be your risk. Then the term we have is the information security. Information security. So information security, just like simply I can say, when I want to protect, when I want to secure my information, even my infrastructure, and my simple IT assets, I want to save them. And the major element of information security, have you heard about CIA?
Yes, confidentiality, integrity, availability.
Yeah, so when we talk about information security, that means I have to be very careful with the elements of the security, which is confidentiality, integrity, availability, and we have one more thing, authenticity. Or simple authentication and authorization. You must have heard about authentication and authorization.
Yes.
One more thing. Yeah, we have repetitions, non-repetition. What is this? Have you heard about this term?
Non-repudiation, you mean?
Yeah.
Yeah. That is that you cannot, that you prove that, that a piece of information comes from a certain account.
Yeah.
And not from someone else. Yeah.
Yeah, right. I can say, like, I cannot deny after sending anything to other person. Like, if I'm sending you a mail, I cannot deny it.
Yeah,
so with
exactly.
this particular non-repudiation, I get that simple, you can say, the trust that this person has sent me this. So afterward, he cannot deny that thing, that he has not sent a mail or something. That thing cannot be done.
Mm.
Okay. So this is the basic terminologies, which is related to it.
I have a question. How do you define information security versus cybersecurity?
Like if I talk about the information security, right? Mm-hmm. So here I'm just focusing on the information. Either I'm getting that information from the internet, either I'm getting it from the simple, when I'm present in an organization, I will be having some information, right? Maybe like you are using your email ID, like you have the email ID of your company, organization, right? So they have some information, you have some information in that part. So you, when you are protecting that information, that is considered as an information security. Both terms are, you can say, similar. Both terms are similar, but it is specifically for the information. And when I talk about the cybersecurity, I'm talking about the broad thing. I'm including different networks also. I need to protect them. I will be talking about everything which is present in an organization that needs a security, so even it can be a gateway. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Would you say that information security is part of cybersecurity?
I can't say that it's a part of a cybersecurity, but I'm saying that it is specifically for the information which we talk about. It is specific. Like if I talk about the confidentiality, so I'm actually talking about the confidentiality of an information. So that's why they have given the term as an information security.
Okay.
Just like that. You cannot say it's a part. Like there are different terminologies. There are different terminologies. So I can't be sure that maybe there's a possibility we can say, but I don't think so. In a similar way, it can be related to that. So that is possible. Okay. I think Okay. So next we have is the simple, what is the difference between the information, data, and the intelligence? Okay, can you tell me?
Information is something that I can actually use.
Okay.
As in,
what happened?
It's usable. What happened? I'm just thinking.
Okay. No issues, no issues. Like, okay, let me tell you.
Data,
like,
if can I talk, be a piece. Yeah,
tell me.
No, just data is something, here, as it says here. It doesn't include, it doesn't give me any context, Yeah, meaningful. That's what I wanted to say. Information becomes meaningful, But I don't know what the difference is now with information and intelligence.
Okay, let me tell you, like if I talk about the simple thing, like if we talk about simple, this is the screen we are showing you. So this is the simple information. When you get it, process it. Simple way. The things you are having around yourself is just a data. Once it makes something, like here you can see there is a session is going on. Like we are on a Microsoft team and some session is going on. So from the same, or you can say small data, we have got this information, like some session is going on in this part. So that will be your information. When you have some something to say, and some simple, I can say, which when you process the data to collect some facts, that can be your information, right? That can be your information. And when we talk about the intelligence, so in that case, we are going broader into that particular part, broader into the information. So here you can say, like from the operational environment, I'm going to collect the data first, which is actually a data collection. From that data, I'm going to process the data to get the information, right? From processing the data, I will get some information. And when I do some analysis on that information data I've collected, I'm going to go into the broader part of that particular information. And then I can say that will be your intelligence.
Okay.
Like, for example, I can say, like, consider some host machine is there and it is communicating to the server. Right? Some host machine is there and it is communicating to the server. Now, here you can say, if you talk about the data, some connection request will be sent to the remote host to the server. Right? Okay, just a second. Like, here I can say, if this is the host machine and this is the server. This is the server, and they are communicating. They are communicating. So here you can say, simple, if I talk about the data, so data can be like when you have sent some connection request. You can say like HTTP request is being sent to the server. Simple request you are sending, right? From the host to the server. Similarly, you can obtain the IP address. We have some IP address of the host. We have some MAC address. Similarly, we have the IP address and MAC address for the server also. So these small things can be considered as a data. And for the information, when I process it, so I can say the connection is being established between the host machine and the server. Right? And there is a multiple connection. I can send multiple requests to the server to make a connection. Even if you have heard about the TCP connection, have you heard about the TCP connection?
Yes.
Yeah. So what happened in this part is we first send the sync packet, right? We send the sync packet and we get the response as sync and acknowledgement, and then again send the acknowledgement part. So here you can see, if I talk about the information, so here the information will be the simple connection, TCP connection, which is called as a three-way handshake, right? Mm-hmm. So that will be considered as your information. That will be your information. And when I talk about the intelligence, so from this information, I need to identify, is there any attack is possible, some threat I'm having, something which is related to this part. Like I can say, okay, I think you must have heard about the man in the middle attack.
Yes.
Right. So this is the intelligence. Like from this information, what you have extracted or analyzed, that there is a possibility of an attack, like man in the middle attack can be possible. Okay.
Can you go up to the data again? What was the data piece?
Data can be like simply getting the simple request you are sending, some IP address, the IP address of this MAC address, the simple thing. Data can be anything. Like for data, you need to be clear about the things. Everything you get is a data. Anything can be a data. Even this screen can be a data, which you are seeing now.
Mm. And information, what makes the data an information?
Like from the data, I'm getting something meaningful. Or I can say when I process the data, I get something. Like from here, I can say there is some TCP connection is going on. So that is the information.
Okay.
If you want to make it more clear, I can say like if in your organization, there are 4 and 5 people are sitting. Okay, in a meeting room, there are 4 and 5 people are sitting. So you can say that is the data. The 5 people are there, some board is there, some is using, you can say some people are using laptop, or you can say some is on the simple digital board, they are on the board. So these small things can be a data. Now, what you get from the data, like maybe some meeting is going on, right? There's a possibility. Maybe they have given some task. Maybe they are like simply, you can say they are the risk management team and they are working on that part, right? That can be the information, right? And from there, from the past and the future experience, like I've talked about this man in the middle attack, how I knew? Because in the man in the middle attack, it actually go into the TCP connection. Once it is established, it act in the middle of the conversation and then send the packet, right? In a similar way, when you talk about that meeting room, here you can identify from the past record or from the previous or a future record that maybe some information, right, they will be talking about some particular risk. Or some meeting has already happened from the last 2 or 3 months, so they are going with the same thing. That is called as an intelligence, where you think about the things that what happened in the past scenario, what can happen in the future scenario, or what is your current expectation of this meeting. From there, you can do the intelligence thing.
Okay, got it.
Okay, I think that is clear to you. The basic information, simple difference between the data, information, and the intelligence.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, next we have is the intelligence-led security testing. I don't know what is happening to this now, right?
Yeah, it's very slow. I'm trying to also open it in parallel on mine, and it doesn't even load at all.
Okay, I think maybe some issue at the EC console part.
Mm.
No issues. We will go with the topic wise. Then next we have is the intelligence-led security testing. So have you heard about the security testing, how it works?
Well, you can do, for example, pen tests. Is that what you mean?
Yeah, you can talk about the pen testing also.
Yeah, you test your security controls if they are functioning towards mitigating risk.
Yeah. like in a simple term, I can say it is based on the scenarios and simple the use cases you have, right? Mm. Some yeah. test cases you can create and go with the software testing. So when we talk about intelligent led, so what we are talking about here is just like whenever there is an organization and they need to extract some intelligence, threat intelligence, so they have to first uncover the known and the unknown threat, right? Known and the unknown threats, whether there is a possibility known threat, I can say, where you can say some vulnerabilities there and can lead to some risk. Simply, vulnerability is known and there is a possibility of non-risk also. So you can identify the attack. Based on unknown, I can say simply when you don't know the particular simple fix for that particular threat, like I can say a 0-day, like we don't know the simple patches for the particular vulnerability at that time. So they can go with that unknown threats, right? So from here, in this particular part, in the security testing approach, I can say you should be very careful with the simple thing, like how should the security testing be conducted, how you're going to perform it, what type of attack methods can be simulated, what types of attack method you're going to include, and where should they focus on their resources, the types of resources you are going to consider it. Okay, and here you also gonna test the critical IT resources which is present, like maybe any remedy or some mitigation is required for the risk, you can include it. Similarly, if there are different, I can say, existing some threat present, which is a simple threat scenario is given to you, and based on this you can try to get more information about it. Like if I talk about simple intelligence over an organization, so I can say why the organization is being targeted. You have to find the reason. What is the reason behind it that they have targeted this particular organization, and how they are planning to attack. How they are planning to attack, that is also important. And you can say simple, who is the attacker? Who is actually planning to do all this thing? So this can be included in this part. Mm-hmm. Okay. Then we can also say, if I talk about myself, like being a part of our security team, if I have to go with the intelligent-led security testing, I will be having some new sets of intelligence. And that can only be possible when I'm having the knowledge of the past scenario and the current scenario going in an organization. If I'm clear about that thing, the past scenario and the current scenario, I can actually build a new set of intelligence. Okay. I mm-hmm. will be building the new set of intelligence. Plus, I can say when I talk about the intelligence, I need to be very careful. Like I have to take care about it and be specific. I need to be very specific to that. Like at what part I'm actually going to do the testing, but I need to be very careful with that. Similarly, when we apply, we can simply say we can apply the threat hunting, right? We can go with the threat hunting. Threat hunting is just like endless process. It's a continuous process you have to work with, right? It's an endless process, and it actually works with some, you can say, you have some idea about the threat hunting?
Not a lot.
Okay, so if I simply talk about the threat hunting, I can say like there is a indicator of attacks. You must have heard about indicators of compromise, right? Indicator of compromise. Yeah, so there is a indicator of attacks also, indicators of exploitation also. So when I'm doing some threat hunting, I will be, it is an endless process. I'm continuously going to work on it. And it is actually based on the indicator of compromise, indicator of attack, indicator of exploitation. Everything will be included. And once I get some threat, I can say I need to be very particular in the defense part also. Right? I have to go with the defense part also.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Okay, just a second.
I just want, can I also ask a question?
Yeah, sure. Tell me.
I can see that you have a version 1 open, yeah, the book.
Yeah, right.
And I don't have that. I don't have version 1. It just says nothing. And I can't really find the page you're on because I'm looking page 30 you have open.
Okay, okay. Actually, it's a instructor PPT. It's an instructor PPT, not for a student.
Right. But the so the PowerPoint, these whatever graphics here, I cannot see the same.
Yeah, it is not the same, but you can say actually you will also have this. Yeah, you will have this. You will have this, but with the explanation also.
Ah, okay. So it's not like for like in terms of the pages. Okay, got it.
Yeah, it will not. It's a instructor PPT.
Okay, no problem.
It's an instructor PPT, which I'm using.
Understood. Okay? All right.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So this is about simple. And when we talk about pen testing, it's just right. You have to find the vulnerability, test for the vulnerability. You will be having the list of vulnerability and then working on it. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, next we have is a simple cyber threat intelligence. The definition we are going to cover, the different stages. Then we have the characteristics and benefits. Then objective, then how the simple threat intelligence help the organization. Types of the intelligence, then its generation, simple. How the, you can say simply threat intelligence inform the risk management. Integration of intelligence with the SIM, that is also important. Then organizational scenario, enhanced, okay. EIR is enhanced incident response. This is also important when we are working with threat intelligence. We should be careful about it. Then how the organization and the analyst expect to, what their responsibility and the use cases. So starting with the simple definition of the cyber threat intelligence. So in a simple term, we can say here, we are gonna collect and analyze the information about some threat or advisory by, we can say, simply drawing the patterns, by getting some knowledge decision, some preparation, prevention, and the different response action I can plan, right? There are cyber attacks which is possible. So based on that, I need to be simply collect the information and analyze it. Simple, doing the cyber threat intelligence is collecting the information and analyzing it. Like, for example, I have given the TCP connection. So once you collect that information that some connection is going on, so there is a possibility of an attack, which is man-in-the-middle attack. Even you have heard about the session hijacking?
Yes.
Yeah, so that is also possible in that particular connection, TCP connection. Okay, then it is going to help you to identify and mitigate various business risks. You can do that thing also by converting the unknown threats to the known threats. Once you can say simply, if you get to know the particular threat is there, so you need to be sure that two thing is there. Like you need to find the vulnerability first and you need to fix it. You need to fix it. So when I say the known thing, the known thing means you know the vulnerabilities, you know the fixes, and you can work on that. When something is unknown, like for example, you know that there is a vulnerability. So you need to convert that thread into the known thread by just, you can say, considering or writing into that particular thread database that this is the thread and that will be considered as a known thread. And you need to find the fix also. You need to find the fix also for that particular part. That is important. So that's why we, when we talk about the cyber threat intelligence, we talk about the simply getting the things and even go with the defense strategies. That is also important. Okay, so here the term we were talking about is knowns and unknowns. So when I talk about the knowns and unknowns, it start with unknown and unknowns, like no vulnerability is known. No fixes available, no vulnerabilities is there. Known and unknown is just like you know the vulnerability. First, we are finding that this is the vulnerability. Now you need to find the fix for that. Then known and known that you know the vulnerability and you know the fix also. That can be your known and known. Is that clear?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. So start with like, I don't know anything. I don't know any vulnerability. I don't know any fixes to it. Simply the 0 day, I can say. If I'm not able to give the patches on a same day, then it can be an attack. Right? Okay, yeah. Then we have the different characteristics of threat intelligence. So here I can say I'm gonna collect the data from the multiple sources. I can go with the open sources. I can use the data feeds. I can use the internal sources. And even the external sources can also gonna help me to collect simple data from there. Then I can go with prioritizing the alert based on simple, you can say whatever things is going on. I will create some customized things, customized alert, and make them priority based on the thread I'm gonna identify, right? If I see that this thread, this particular thread has a higher vulnerabilities and you can say higher possibility of attack, in that case, I can customize my alert. Then it is gonna identify the indicator of compromise. I can easily identify that. I can go with the new protection strategies because I'm going with the defense part also. I'm providing the fix also. So it means I'm giving the protection strategies. Then I can go with like providing the active campaign, like who, what, when, and how the security threats is actually emerging in an organization. You need to be very careful with that, right? Then you have to go with the probability of risk, how it's going to impact your business. That is also important. Recommending the various remediation and the mitigation solution. Like you work in a risk management team, so I think some of the things you are already doing it, right?
Yes.
Yeah, you're already doing some of the things. The point is now you have to collect the data, and here you need to identify the threats related to them and go with the defense part also in a similar term. Next, we have the benefit. So in simple term, I can say it's going to provide me the greater insight into the cyber threat. It gives me more information about it in a similar way. Then it can prevent the data loss by identifying if there any data leakage is there. So I can identify the data leakage and try to protect it. Guiding the incident response. If some incident happens, some threat is going to give rise to an attack, you can actually guide the incident response also, that how you are going to respond to that particular threat incident happening. Then we can go with the conducting the data analysis for simply identifying the exploitable data, which is possible for an attack, providing the actionable strategies and the tactical choices, conducting the threat analysis, for advanced threats, you want to detect them also. Sharing the threat information to simply spread the awareness. Like once you find some threat, you actually make everyone aware about it so that they are able to protect themselves, they are able to defend themselves. Then they need to identify the indicator of compromise, discovering the simple TTPs, just like tactics, technique, and procedure. Simple, what technique is used by the attackers? What techniques they use? The similar way you have to discover that technique, and you should be knowing the procedure they're going to follow for that particular attack. And based on that, you can plan the defense. Then we have the enterprise objective for this particular program. Like we have enhanced and automated incident prevention. Like whenever we go with simple incident prevention, when I talk about this, it's just like organization need to improve their internal security control, right? They need to improve and work on the internal security control. If they're not able to work on them, they actually need to improve and automate the prevention, right? Automation is also important. So when I talk about the incident prevention, so I just want that they should automate their incident prevention mechanism, whatever they're not going to use for that, that should be automated. Then automation of security operation and remedial activities. Similar way, I can say when there is any decision-making process is going on, you need to be focused on the different, you can say simply the process or expect which are going on in an organization. You need to be careful about it. Then the guidance to the cybersecurity activities is just like you have to make sure that there are different activities, security activities going on. So you need to be simply, I can say, you need to guide your organization that they should focus on those activity and implement so many activities that everyone should be aware about it, that we actually need the security parts. And if there is any possibility of threats, like you can say in a vulnerability part, the human being is the most vulnerable. Mm-hmm. Human beings are the most vulnerable because there are, you have heard about the social engineering attack.
Yeah.
That is a lot actually happening. And once your assets, the human being asset is at risk, you can say, if they are vulnerable, anyone is able to gather some data or information from there, then there is a bigger threat. That will be a bigger threat in an organization. Okay. Okay, then we need to go with the improved risk management. Simple terms, you have to improve it, like improve the efficiency of the process. That will be enough. Improving the incident detection. You have to simply, in many organizations, you have heard that a simple, whenever you are going with the detection part, incident detection part, you actually identify the different threats. You identify the different threats with the help of the indicators of compromise. Then you go with the TTP. What are the different techniques? You can say simply which is taken by the attackers. Do you work on that? Okay. So, okay. Like, have you ever used any smartwatch, like any Apple smartwatch or some other?
No.
Okay. So if we talk about simple smartwatches, like they have a lack of privacy. I can say when we talk about an Apple company, they actually give us a quick response. Whenever is there any threat they identify, they give us a quick response to any vulnerability which is encounter, any threat they encounter. But what happened with the other companies, they are not that much effective. Like they are actually collecting our data, whatever, like they go with our heartbeat or something, heart rate, what is the heart rate? So they can identify the medical issue related to any person who is using their smartwatch.
Yeah,
and based on that, that data is being collected. And actually, you can say they sell that data, right? And if I talk about the social media, we actually are on the social media. So any idea how you can protect yourself from that?
Oh, God. I mean, privacy settings, etc. But in the end, not much.
Yeah.
I think once you go in social media, that's it.
Right? Yeah. Like here you can also see there is so many threat which is related to the social media. Like we need any person, anyone, you can say everyone need to be protected from there. And for that, the simple way, that person should be aware about the threats, aware about the secure, simple privacy settings and all. Simple. If the person is that much intelligent, simple, the intelligence is there. If the human being is using his intelligence, then he can protect it. Like you can say there are so many people who actually post many things, many personal things over the social media platform. So at that case, you cannot protect them, right? You cannot protect that data and information. You cannot protect it because you are already sharing it with the whole, your that internet part. You're publishing your personal information. So how and whom you wanted to protect that data? It's all up to you, what information you are sharing. So that's why for every threat intelligence person, you need to be very sure that once you are in an organization, you need to go with the different prevention part. Like we have the incident prevention, simple automating the security operation. Be careful with any indicator of compromise which is present, and be enhanced with the technologies. Be enhanced. The different things you can include it. Right?